Welcome to another NECA figure review. This time we're looking at the Xenomorph Warrior from the Aliens line. Now, this is one of the more popular designs for the Xenomorph, just because I think Aliens was a little bit more financially successful and just a little bit more marketable, because you got multiple aliens, you got Marines fighting them, just a bit more action, and they altered the design. A lot of people seem to favor this one just because it's a little bit more, I don't know, necessarily scary. It's just like more traditional monster-like. Like what they, and basically what they did was they took off the dome and saw all this cool texture detail, which you can vaguely see on the original Xenomorph, but they covered up the eye socket, so you just got this blank black slate in the front of his head. Now, let's take a look at his head, and there is vast detail here. For the most part, it does have the exact same detail like for the rest of the body that the original has, except for some minor alterations in the design, and we'll get to those in a second. But you can see, especially in the head here, got the added ridges here, kind of a more insect animal like physique, especially the way that the Xenomorph Warrior just handles itself. It's got these kind of, I don't know how else to describe them, but things coming off of its forearm, which serve little to no purpose. And the way he holds his hands is a little bit more animal-like. His feet are also changed now, except like they got these toes protruding out from the sides, as opposed to kind of the more, you know, just flat-footed look that the original Xenomorph had. And this one has a bluish tint to it, while the original one was more of a black and gray, which I like better. He's got, what else is different? Really, that's about it as far as major differences go. Except for the hands, the feet, the things on the forearms and the head. And the paint job, it's more or less the same. The articulation is the same. It does, of course, have a opposable jaw, and it does have a secondary mouth, which is a little bit harder to get out on this one than the first one, which is kind of funny. But it does come out, and that thing comes off of mine a lot too. This piece that's supposed to come off or go and stay in here, I'll probably get the super glue that piece in there. It does, it looks terrifying. It's not exactly my favorite alien design, but this is a lot of people's preferred alien, and I totally understand. It's just for nostalgic reasons, I really like the original drone a lot better. But this is a very, very cool look. And if you're just wanting to go for like a definitive alien, and this would probably be the more iconic one to go for, because there's so many different variations of the alien design, but this one is probably the most common alien design and just the most recognizable one. Yeah, I definitely recommend this guy. Of course, let's go to articulation real quick. He's got the thing in the neck, you know, it's exact same. He's got the swivel in the hip, nice stiff shoulder, elbow, wrist swivel, double edged knee, and a little bit of foot articulation. And this one, just by the way he holds himself, except for that right there, that's kind of funny. You can get him into some really creepy poses, especially, you know, just if you know exactly what to do with his hands, which obviously I do not. It does not look good the way I'm doing it. All right, you can follow me at Twitter at twitter.com/SSJArmont. You can Instagram me too, SSJArmont, and you can follow me at Twitch at twitch.tv/SSJ_Autobot. And I'll catch you next time. Bye bye.